Hey guys, right now we are in the factory in which one of our most famous air coolers produced, the Darkrock 3. It is unfortunately quite loud, but also really, really hot. Marius, can you tell me why?
Well, that is easy to answer. If you take a look in the back, you can see that this oven has a temperature of 980 degrees Celsius. And in this oven, our heat pipes are being baked.
So let's start from scratch. In a CPU cooler, the heat pipes conduct heat from the base plate to the fins. This means they are an integral part of the overall cooling process. But before these pretty copper pieces are ready to keep a CPU up and running, the manufacturing process starts with a very big roll, from which a long, really long copper pipe is first coiled up. In a special machine with an awe-inspiring force of 47 Newton meters, this coil is pulled out straight and then chopped into long pieces in a deafening process. The future heat pipes are next cleaned in a special cleaning solvent with the help of ultrasound. In the next stage, one end of the heat pipe is compacted and pressed into a taper. The small hole on one side is to permit its later filling with a liquid coolant. The heat pipe is now filled with a mixture of copper powder, while a centrally positioned and powerful vibrating steel tube ensures the mixture is evenly distributed as it is filled. That is an extremely important step, because without the correct amount of copper powder in the pipe, it would not transfer heat properly later on, which would essentially make the heat pipe useless. The spaces left behind when the vibrating steel tube is removed are where steam will later flow through, and the copper powder combines under extremely high temperatures with the copper pipe to form copper capillaries, through which condensed water is transported back towards the heat source. The heat pipes with the copper mixture are now placed under a thick heating cover and baked at a staggering 980 degrees, a process that takes about 8 hours. After this, the result is cooled by 3 fans running at full blast. This vital baking stage of the process is called sintering. After the cooling stage of the process, the copper pipes are filled with the coolant, which is based on distilled water, about 2 mm per pipe. In the final stages of the process, all the air is sucked out of the copper pipe. In fact, twice over, to be absolutely sure nothing remains. And to finish it off, the pipe is completely closed with an airtight seal. In the next video, we will show you what becomes of the heat pipes and how they are combined with other components to make a finished air cooler.